सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन गाइस वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज व्हिच आर रेलेवेंट फॉर द ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एंड नबार्ड एग्जाम्स। ओके सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन इफ यू आर न्यू हियर डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन ताकि आपको वीडियोस की नोटिफिकेशन मिल सके। सो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। Consider the following statements regarding the amendments and approvals made in post-matric scholarship scheme for SC students, and you have to identify the correct statements regarding this amendments and approvals that has been made in this post-matric scholarship scheme for SC student. So guys, Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, which is chaired by the Prime Minister of India, has amended and also provided some approvals in the post-matric scholarship scheme for the SC students, and उसमें एक बहुत बड़ा approval ये किया गया है कि ₹59,048 crore की investment government ने announce की है, okay? So let's discuss the news, guys. But before we move on to the amendments and approvals, let's talk about the scheme first. Post-matric scholarships for SC. So guys, this scheme has the objective to provide financial assistance to SC students, as the name suggests, who are studying at the post-matriculation to enable them to complete their higher education. जो SC student matriculation के बाद, यानी कि class 10th के बाद पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं, अगर उनके पास funds की कमी है तो उनको financial assistance provide कराने के लिए this scheme was launched. And guys, इसका जो launch है, it is not clear. Okay, कहीं पे 2013-14 लिखा हुआ है, कहीं पे 2012-13 लिखा हुआ है. So, एक बार अगर कंफर्म हो जाएगा देन आई विल टेल यू। ओके एंड व्हाट इज द मिनिस्ट्री, इट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट, एंड देयर इज आल्सो अ सीलिंग ऑन द फैमिलीज इनकम व्हिच इज हाउ मच, ₹2,50,000 पर एनम। जो फैमिली की इनकम है वो 2.5 लाख पर एनम से ज्यादा नहीं होनी चाहिए। किसकी फैमिली? द स्टूडेंट हु इज गेटिंग बेनिफिट अंडर दिस पोस्ट मैट्रिक स्कॉलरशिप स्कीम फॉर एससी स्टूडेंट्स। ओके सो आई होप गाइस द स्कीम इज क्लियर। स्कीम में इतना ही है, ज्यादा कुछ नहीं है। इट इज जस्ट अ स्कॉलरशिप स्कीम फॉर एससी स्टूडेंट्स who are pursuing their higher education after matriculation, और उनकी जो फैमिली की इनकम है वो 2.5 लाख से ज्यादा नहीं होनी चाहिए। alright, and talking about guys the amendments and approvals, so the most important approval in this scheme is that the total investment of ₹59,048 crore has been approved. okay, total कितना? 59,048 crore का investment किया जाएगा in this scheme, and out of this amount ₹35,534 crore, which is approximately 60%, will be invested by the central government, and the rest 40% will be invested by the respective state governments. Okay, and the central assistance, guys, which was around ₹1,100 crore during 2017-18 to 2019-20, will be increased by 5 times to around ₹6,000 crore. This should be crore, 6,000 crore annually for the upcoming 5 years. यानी कि 2021 से 2025-26 तक आने वाले 5 सालों में जो गवर्नमेंट की इन्वेस्टमेंट है, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट की इन्वेस्टमेंट, जो कि पहले अराउंड 1100 crore थी, दैट विल बी इंक्रीज टू हाउ मच, ₹6,000 crore इन द अपकमिंग 5 years। एंड रिमेंबर वन थिंग, दैट इट इज एस्टिमेटेड दैट अराउंड 4 करोड़ एससी स्टूडेंट्स विल गेट बेनिफिट थ्रू दीज अमेंडमेंट्स एंड अप्रूवल्स। ओके एंड टॉकिंग मोर अबाउट दीज अमेंडमेंट्स, सो द कैंपेन विल बी लॉन्च टू एनरोल द स्टूडेंट्स फ्रॉम द पुअरेस्ट हाउस होल्ड हू हैव पास द क्लास 10th, and according to and after the releasing of this campaign, it is estimated that around 1.36 crore poor SC students will be benefited, or unko higher education system se connect kiya ja sakega in the upcoming 5 years. Okay, so through this campaign, it is estimated that around 1.36 crore poor SC students will get benefit in the upcoming 5 years, and they will be connected to the higher education system. Okay, and the scheme, guys, will run on an online platform with robust cyber security measure to ensure the accountability, to ensure the efficiency of the system. Okay, and the transfer of financial assistance to the students will be through the direct benefit transfer mode. Okay, so these are some amendments and these are some approvals which have been made by the Cabinet Committee and on Economic Affairs, and this is the most important. Okay, this is the most important point here. Another very important is this campaign. ये जो campaign है ये काफी ज़्यादा important है, because government is saying that 1.36 crore poor SC students को फायदा हम देंगे in the upcoming 5 years. Right? So now let's come back to the question. What was the question? We have to identify the correct statements regarding this amendment and approval. So the total investment of rupees 59,048 crore has been approved. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And out of this, 60% will be invested by the central government, while rest of the 40% will be invested by the state governments. Overall investment will be done by the central government. No, overall पूरा का पूरा सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट का नहीं होगा. 60% एज आई टोल्ड यू ऑफ द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, वाइल 40% ऑफ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, विच मीन्स दिस स्टेटमेंट इज इनकरेक्ट. एंड अराउंड 1.36 करोड़ एससी स्टूडेंट्स विल बी ब्रॉट अंडर हायर एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन द अपकमिंग 5 इयर्स. दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट थ्रू दैट कैंपेन विच विल बी लॉन्च्ड फॉर द पुअर एससी स्टूडेंट्स. अराउंड 1.36 करोड़ पुअर एससी स्टूडेंट्स विल बी connected through the higher education system in the upcoming 5 years. Okay, which means this statement is absolutely correct and we have to identify the correct statements. And option A, only 1 and 3 will be the correct answer here. And now let's move on to question number 2. How much amount government has planned to invest in creating gas infrastructure till 2024 to increase the share of gas in energy sector? So guys, the government is planning to invest $60 billion. Okay, how much? $60 billion in the gas sectors to create the gas infrastructure and thereby increasing the share of gas in the energy mix to 15% by the year 2030. जो गैस का शेयर है इन द एनर्जी सेक्टर और यू कैन से इन द एनर्जी मिक्स 15% कर देंगे बाय द ईयर 2030, विच इज करेंटली अराउंड 6%. ओके, which is currently around 6%, इसको increase करके कितना कर देंगे? 15% by the year 2030, and the total investment is how much? $60 billion. That's it. इसमें आपको इतना ही पढ़ना है. So therefore, the correct answer is what? Option C, $60 billion. Okay. And this question, guys, can be asked in the one marker of ESI. So this is also very important because these days we are talking more about the infrastructure development. So this is about the infrastructure, gas infrastructure. So therefore, this question becomes very important. Okay. And now question number 3. Which of the following international organizations has launched COVID-19 vaccine market dashboard to enable countries to follow the development of vaccine market? So this vaccine market dashboard, guys, has been launched by UNICEF. Kisne launch kiya hai? UNICEF ne launch kiya hai. Aur ye kya hai, iske bare mein baat kar lete hain. Let's talk more about this. So UNICEF has launched this COVID-19 vaccine market dashboard, and it will enable countries, partners and industries to have the access of the COVID-19 vaccine market. कहां पे कितना प्रोडक्शन हो रहा है, कहां पे किस तरीके की वैक्सीन बन रही है, कितनी मैन्युफैक्चरिंग हो रही है, सारी इंफॉर्मेशन विल बी प्रोवाइडेड थ्रू दिस डैशबोर्ड. ओके, एंड टॉकिंग मोर अबाउट दिस डैशबोर्ड गाइस, सो इट विल ऑफर एन अपडेटेड ओवरव्यू ऑफ द ग्लोबल रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट पाइपलाइन रिलेटेड टू द COVID-19 वैक्सीन और ऑल्सो द प्रोजेक्टेड प्रोडक्शन कैपेसिटी ऑफ द कोविड वैक्सीन, सो दैट हमें ये पता चल सके कि हमारी जो पॉपुलेशन है वर्ल्ड की और जो प्रोडक्शन है वो आपस में कितना लिंक करता है. ओके, so that we can identify the link between the population of the world and the production linked capacity. Okay, and the dashboard will be expanded to see the progress towards the goal of COVAX facility to achieve 2 billion COVID vaccination by the end of 2021. And I hope guys you all remember about the COVAX facility we have discussed in a very recent session. So uska goal hai kya hai, to achieve 2 billion vaccine dosages by the end of 2021. So usko जो जितने भी हमारी कंट्रीज हैं उसको वो रिव्यू कर सकती हैं. ओके, एंड द डैशबोर्ड विल ऑफर एन अपडेट अबाउट यूनिसेफ स्टेटस ऑफ प्रोक्योरमेंट एंड अदर बायर्स पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन द कोवैक्स फैसिलिटी. ओके, सो गाइस दीज आर जस्ट फॉर द बेसिक इन्फॉर्मेशन. द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन हियर इज दैट COVID-19 वैक्सीन मार्केट डैशबोर्ड हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय यूनिसेफ टू विच विल इनेबल कंट्रीज पार्टनर्स एंड इंडस्ट्रीज टू हैव द एक्सेस ऑफ COVID-19 वैक्सीन मार्केट. दिस इज जस्ट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जाम एंड दीज पॉइंट्स गाइस यू कैन यूज इन ऐसे टाइप ऑफ थिंग्स. ओके, सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट? ऑप्शन डी, यूनिसेफ. ऑप्शन डी, यूनिसेफ इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 एंड 5 आर गाइस बेस्ड ऑन द रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ प्रायर लर्निंग प्रोग्राम. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस न्यूज फर्स्ट. व्हाट इज द न्यूज? रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ प्रायर लर्निंग प्रोग्राम. व्हाट इज दिस प्रोग्राम एंड हु हैज लॉन्च्ड इट? अंडर विच प्रोग्राम इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड? सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस. सो द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्किल डेवलपमेंट एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. So now can you tell me who is the Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship? Write down in the comments. मैं कई बार बता चुका हूं आपको. Is conducting a special recognition of prior learning program with the Department of Panchayati Raj. किसके साथ हो रहा है ये? Department of Panchayati Raj के साथ इसको launch किया जाएगा. And remember one thing that this program guys has been launched under the Sankalp program. Under the संकल्प प्रोग्राम ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्किल डेवलपमेंट एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप एंड व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ संकल्प इट इज स्किल एक्विजिशन एंड नॉलेज अवेयरनेस फॉर लाइवलीहुड प्रमोशन स्किल एक्विजिशन एंड नॉलेज अवेयरनेस फॉर लाइवलीहुड प्रमोशन प्रोग्राम ओके एंड रिमेंबर वन मोर थिंग दैट इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड एज अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट इन टू डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश विच आर वाराणसी एंड चंदौली ओके वाराणसी और चंदौली में इसको लॉन्च किया गया आफ्टर इट विल बी अ सक्सेस देन इट विल बी लॉन्च्ड इन होल कंट्री सो नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द प्रोग्राम व्हाट इज द दिस प्रोग्राम सो गाइस दिस प्रोग्राम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड टू रिकॉग्नाइज द वैल्यू ऑफ लर्निंग अक्वायर्ड आउटसाइड ऑफ फॉर्मल सेटिंग ओके फॉर्मल सेटिंग के बाहर अगर किसी ने कोई लर्निंग कोई स्किल सीखा है तो उसको रिकॉग्नाइज करने के लिए दिस प्रोग्राम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड and the government will also provide a certificate for an individual skills and after and by doing this government will formalize the informal skills okay government will formalize the informal skills of the people who have acquired those skills outside the formal setting and it will also help in enhancement of their livelihood and candidate guys will receive exposure to the digital and financial literacy and they will also get an accidental insurance coverage for 3 years at free of cost and no fees charged koi fees nahi hogi from a candidate participating in this program or certificate lene ke baad usko kitne rupaye milenge 500 rupaye every successfully certified candidate will rupees 500 as an award all right and talking about the sankalp program so I hope this this new program recognition of prior learning is clear so basically it is to recognize the value of those learning which have been acquired outside a formal setting and government is doing what government is formalizing the informal skills that have been acquired outside the formal setting or outside a formal institution all right or certificate ke baad kitne rupaye milenge 500 rupaye and talking about the sankalp program guys so it was launched in the year 2018 to strengthen the institutional mechanism for skill development ke liye jo institutional mechanism hai usko strengthen karne ke liye this program was launched in the year 2018 and it has an implementation period till March 2023 तक इसका implementation period है and it is supported by World Bank और World Bank का कितना support है इसमें $500 million okay so and it has the four key areas the Sankalp program guys has four key areas and which are these institutional strengthening at the center state and district and what are these institutions these are the institutions related to the skill development of course quality assurance of skill development program inclusion of marginalized population in the skill development program and expanding skills through public private partnership so these are the four key areas of sankalp program and it was launched in the year 2018 remember its implementation period is till March 2023 and world bank has provided $500 million for implementation of this scheme okay so now let's move on to question number 4 and 5 so question number 4 and 5 is based on the recognition of prior learning program and the sankalp program so let's talk about question number 4 consider the following statement regarding recognition of prior learning program and you have to identify the incorrect statements so this project has been launched as a pilot project in Mirzapur and Kanpur so is that Mirzapur and Kanpur no it's Varanasi and Chandoli which means the very first statement is incorrect implementing agency is directorate general of training it is not directorate general of training it is NSDC okay so write down one more thing the implementing agency for this program is national skill development corporation here I think it is not written yes so remember one more thing the implementing agency is what NSDC national skill development corporation and which means guys the statement number 2 is also incorrect and every successfully certified candidate will get rupees 5000 so that is not 5000 that's 500 which means this statement is also incorrect all the statement guys here are incorrect and we have to identify the incorrect statements which means option E all are incorrect will be the correct answer and question number 5 consider the following statements regarding sankalp program of MSDE and you have to identify the correct statement here now this question is specifically about the Sankalp program okay so this program is supported by the Asian Development Bank no it is being supported guys by World Bank which has provided $500 million which means this statement is incorrect it has the implementation period till March 2023 yes this is absolutely correct and it was launched in 2014. No, not 2014, it was launched in 2018, which means this is also incorrect. And we have to identify the correct statements here, which means option B, only two will be the correct answer. So guys, I hope this question number 5 is also clear, and that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.